up now.
Still above ground.
Help! Help!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Marston.
Keep your eyes open, mister.
Hey, excuse me.
Mr. Marston!
Always a pleasure, John. Always a pleasure.
Go!
You a tough guy, mister? I hope so. We gonna have a showdown.
Hello,
I don't miss, mister. Bear that in
Those
mind.
Are big words, my friend. Let's see.
part to keep Blackwater safe, sir.
What do you want, Marston?
My family. I've done what you asked.
No, you haven't. This is the land of opportunity, and I gave you the opportunity to save your family, and you failed. How could I possibly reward you?
Marston, you're a public menace. We should have had you killed.
I wish you had. But since you didn't, where's my family?
Oh, spare me the noble savage falling a sore tripe, will you, old boy? It's nauseating. You don't wish to be dead. You're an insignificant creature, desperately clinging on to life like the rest of the scum in this town. Yeah, I know, it's tough. You like Dutch. He's a charming fellow. He makes sense. He's like one of those nature writers from back east, only he takes things a tiny little step too far. Rather than just loving the flowers and the animals and the harmony between man and beast, he shoots people in the head for money and disagreeing with them.
He's a goddamn killer.
Now, I'm not a great intellect, but the metaphysical leap from admiring the flower to shooting a man in the head because he doesn't like the flower is a leap too far. So, I know it's easy. You see, me and Archer, we're the bad guys. We enforce the rules. Now, while the rules may not be perfect, they're really not so bad.
Exactly. What's the alternative?
See, I'll tell you what the alternative is. It's not complicated. It's about one man and his gun versus another man. Sure, civilization may be dull, but the alternative, Mr. Marston, is hell.
And the way you enforce this civilization, this freedom for men to like or not like flowers, or whatever in God's name you were just talking about, is to kidnap a man's wife and son?
Well, I know there's contradictions. I'm not going to lie to you. As I said, I'm not a great intellect. Now, after the debacle with the army and the bank, we have to put Mr. Vanderlyn to rest ourselves. Will you help us?
Do I have any choice?
Now that you mention it, no.
Then what was that pretty speech in aid of?
I don't rightly know, but it sure felt good saying it.
Shall we, Mr. Marston?
Let's go. Let's see if we can put this to rest once and for all, shall we?
Come quick! Take a look at this thing! Have you seen this? It's got a gun on the back!
In all my born days, I never seen this one.
Iron Dragon! That's the devil's one.
They told me about these. The army's been building them in secret.
Oh my God!
This killing machine of yours seems to be turning a few heads.
Our armed forces have no equal. We have made incredible progress the past few years.
Is that what you call
it? This isn't much more than a simple prototype. You should see what they're working on in Virginia. Soon there will be no war we can't win.
The army has made camp a little way outside town. They put word out a large cache of ammunition and food is stored there.
Vanderlyn's gang needs constant supplies, so that should be enough to draw him in.
No mistakes this time. You hear me, Marston?
I thought you were talking to Fordham.
What's the word, Captain?
We spotted one of Dutch's men about an hour ago. I think he took the bait.
Let's get in position then. Have your men ready to run him down if you have to.
Dismiss! Load weapons and get to the sandbags! Move!
Are you ready to finish this, Mr. Marston?
I guess so.
Keep your eyes peeled. There they are! Open fire!
It's over!
Take them down!
That's enough!
This ends now!
Keep going!
Everybody stay alert! Targets on the horizon! Fire at will!
Hold them off!
Keep coming!
This ends now!
Yes, we're on track.
Keep them back!
If you don't stop that, you ain't gonna live!
What is it with these people?
You have reached
the now! Later. Look out behind those rocks!
Goddamn savages!
right now! Stop shooting at me!
Get those men behind the rocks!
Well, Mr. Marston, it seems like your mentor, Dutch, no longer looks quite so kindly to his student.
That man is insane.
So it seems.
I think we need to get him before sundown.
As you say, Captain. Otherwise, he'll be gone again.
And what if I say no?
Now, before I shoot you myself, let me just point out the obvious. The one person we have left that can appeal to Mr. Vanderlyn is the last person we know who knows him. Your wife.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Ross, Captain, let's go.
Mount up, men. Let's move out.
Let's go. Go! Slow down!
Gate open. Move, soldier! Marston, we'll take two men with us. The rest will stay here and take care of the wounded. They'll plant charges at the gate. You and I will provide the cover fire. This is it, men. Let's get that gate down. Get ready to hold off their fire, Marston. Up top! Cover them!
I gotta face Dutch alone!
Looks like it's me and you, John. You should have stayed at home.
You better follow me. Your father thought he had a...
Too close!
Somebody's over there.
Shame.
I don't have a choice.
There's always a choice. You're just too blind to see.
They got my family.
Your family? Abigail was any man's wife, John. Jack, you've got a horse. Just like son of a bitch. God damn it. You'll never take me alive, John!
Ah! Ah! Ah!
It's over, John!
I ain't leaving here without you!
Just like me, John. You can't change who you are.
I ain't like you.
Go away.
That's where you're wrong.
Hello again, John.
Hello, Dutch.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
Sure.
I got a plan, John.
You always got a plan, Dutch.
This is a good one.
I don't doubt it.
We can't always fight nature, John. We can't fight change. Can't fight gravity. We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John. You see?
Then I have to shoot you.
When I'm gone, they'll just find another monster. They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
Our time has passed, John.
So at the end, you didn't have the guts to shoot him.
The man's dead, Ross.
Sure. Can I see your gun? Oh, trust me. It looks better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Marston, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, you've done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.
Let's go!
Now I know.
That's the flower.
Abigail! Jack! Anyone here? Anyone home? Oh, darling. I never thought I'd see this day again.
You no good hillbilly piece of shit! I thought you was dead! I thought you was dead, John, huh? Where you been?
You know where I've been, darling.
You know!
You saw Dutch, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw him.
And Bill?
Yeah, I saw him too.
And you didn't go back to him?
I left that life. Just as you left yours. How'd they treat you?
Oh, I can take care of myself, John. One guard got funny on me one time, but I wasn't so ladylike, and he didn't try it again. Nor no one else.
How's the boy?
Oh, like you. And like me. Well, he's like a kid growing up without a father.
That ain't fair.
What is fair?
Well, some trees flourish, others die. Some cattle grow strong, others are taken by wolves. Some men are born rich enough and dumb enough to enjoy their lives. Ain't nothing fair, you know that.
We tried to change, ain't that what you're supposed to do?
We did change. And it's over now. Jack! Jack, come here, boy.
Hello, sir.
Come here. How you been?
Coyotes ate all the chickens and poachers took the cattle. I tried, Father. I tried.
I know you did, son. I know.
And don't you go blaming me, boy. Don't you go blaming me.
I ain't blaming no one, old man, but since you're still alive, there's four mouths to feed. And no cattle.
That's a nice way to greet somebody. Why don't I get the warm and tender embrace?
Consider the fact I ain't put a bullet in you, your embrace, old man. You were supposed to look after the place.
I did. Well, I did my best. Thing is, there was too many of them. I thought you was dead. I wasn't drinking.
Hold your excuses until you figured out which one to use. Jack, go get your bags packed, boy. We got work to do. We leave in the morning. Go on.
Yes, sir.
Where are you going?
Well, it's getting kind of dark now, but in the morning we've got to go get ourselves some more cattle.
I've got friends at McFarland's ranch. It's over in Hittigan's stead who can sell us some.
Now, Abigail, I hope you've learned to cook.
Yes. Didn't I say? Rather than some prison, they actually kept me incarcerated in a cooking school for young ladies.
Sir.
All right. We should get moving. Go! How you feeling, Jack?
I'm feeling fine, sir.
We got a decent ride ahead of us.
I've never been to Hennigan's. Careful!
I met him while I was away. The McFarlands are good people. We need folks we can trust right now.
Met them how?
I was sick and they looked after me.
Sick how?
You sure got a lot of questions.
I don't often get a chance to ask them. Was it a gentleman's complaint? What do they call it? The morning drip?
Good God, boy, no! Where do you learn these things?
Uncle told me about it.
Well, he'd know, the dirty old fool.
No, I just got weak for a while. Acted foolishly, got in trouble. Guess I was a little out of practice.
Hey, Paul!
What?
Where were you all that time? Where'd you go?
What'd your mother tell you?
She said it was some kind of important government business.
That's about right. Some people thought I owed them some favors.
Why did they take us away?
They thought it wasn't safe for you here by yourselves. Those men harm you?
No, they're okay. Some of them even told me stories. I think I'd like to be a government man one day, or a politician.
I'd rather you chose an honest profession.
Like you, you mean?
I know I ain't been the best father, Jack. I made some bad choices. But all that life, it's over now.
Paul, was it something to do with Mr. Dutch and Bill? Why you went away?
Who told you that?
Well, I kept hearing people say their names. That's all.
Yeah, I caught up with Bill and Dutch. We had some old business needed settling.
Where are they now?
They're gone, son. We won't be seeing them again.
They were angry at you, weren't they? That's why we had to leave.
They was just good men who turned bad. I'll explain it to you one day.
And what does that make you?
I guess I'm a bad man who tried to be a good father. I don't know. Every man has a right to change. A chance of forgiveness. Ain't that what the good book says?
You've never read me the good book, sir.
Well, I imagine that's what it says. So, you ready to learn about herding cattle?
I've never seen you herd anything, Paul. Apart from the odd pack of drunks.
The McFarlands were good to me, and I helped them out in return. I learned a few things along the way. Wait till you see their ranch. It's what ours will be one day.
I read in the newspaper their ranch is dead. Soon it'll just be factories and businesses around here.
You shouldn't believe everything you read.
I was thinking, maybe I might be a businessman.
I thought you wanted to be a writer.
Well, I could be both. A rich industrialist who writes novels about the Old West on the side.
You can be whatever you want, son, but for now, let's concentrate on getting some food on the table. Unless you're planning on striking literary gold in the next day or two, that is. There's the ranch. Come on, let's see if we can find Mr. McFarlane.
Easy.
Come on, easy up now.
John Marston. Now, there's a face I thought I'd never see again. Some of our public servants in Blackwater sent you back on another homicidal errand to protect and save us from Lord only knows what.
Thankfully not, sir. I was hoping you might still be able to sell me some cattle.
My boy, it would be a pleasure. Bonnie's out the crowd now. She'll be more than happy to help you.
Take care now, Mr. McFarlane. Good luck. All right, Jack. You're gonna have an important job. I want you to lead the herd while I drive them from the back. Keep us all moving in the right direction.
Sure, Paul. I can do that, no problem.
Good Lord, do my eyes deceive me? A devil walks among us.
I said I'd be back when this was all over, Miss McFarlane. After the barn fire, you remember?
Of course I remember. I just didn't believe a word of it. So, you've come for some cattle?
Yeah. I'm finally starting up my farm again. Or trying to, at least.
You'll be fine. You've been taught well. Come on, then.
Come on!
Sometime.
So, what happened? Last I heard, you were headed.
some exotic escapade in Mexico.
Hey!
So, is this your boy?
Yeah! Say hello to Miss McFarland, Jack!
Hello!
Ah, the arrogance of youth. He gets a little fur on his lip and he thinks he knows best all of a sudden.
Let's take after his father.
Come on!
How's your wife?
She's well, I think. We haven't had much time to talk yet.
Well, I'm glad you're back together again.
It's gonna take some time. We've all been through a lot. Come on. How's the ranch?
We're surviving, but it hasn't gotten any easier.
If you're still struggling, there's not much hope for me. Yeah.
Let's go.
Looks like you got him under control. I best get back to Paul.
Nice to see you again, Miss McFarland. And thanks for everything.
Call me Bonnie, you dolt.
All right, Jack. Let's get him through the river. Let's go! think that's all of them. Jack! Wait there! I'm coming! You all right? You're not hurt, are you?
No. I'm fine. I wasn't scared, honest.
Sorry you had to see that, son. Those men won't be stealing from anybody else. Jack! Head left up the road towards home!
I know where I'm going, Paul.
Whoa! Slow up. Come on! Now lead him into the pit! Nice work, son!
We made it!
You did real good out there! Go on! Hit your horse away from me by the stable!
There you go!
That's a fine herd we got ourselves!
So we're ranchers now?
Did a good job, son. Nice shooting.
Thanks, Paul.
Make a rancher of you yet.